This order is recognized.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. I yield myself 2 minutes.
Chairman from Minnesota is recognized for 2 minutes.
Our committee's portion, the infrastructure portion of this recovery program, is targeted. It will be transparent, and recipients will be held accountable. And the investments are desperately needed. The construction sector is suffering the highest unemployment rate of any industrial sector, 15.3%, 1.4 million construction workers out of a job. Fully implemented, as our committee proposes, we can have 1 million workers on a construction site in June of this year and generate $325 billion in total economic activity when fully implemented. Jobs that cannot be outsourced to other countries, using materials that are made in America, not outsourced beyond our shores. Transparency. We require reporting by every state DOT, every transit agency, every airport authority, every 30 days, on the contracts awarded, by contract, on the specific jobs, job description, and payroll, which we will receive and make public through hearings that we'll conduct 30 days after the funding is allocated to the states and every 60 days thereafter. An accountability, an amendment which I expect hope to offer tomorrow, made in order by the Rules Committee, will have a requirement that funds be committed in 90 days, use it or lose it. Reserve the balance of my time. This amendment will shorten the time that states, cities, transit agencies, aviation authorities have to obligate 50% of the highway, transit, and aviation funds provided under this Recovery Act to 90 days from the proposed 180 days. I've had extensive consultations over the past 5 months with state and local officials about creating jobs by June to show that we can deliver economic recovery to this country. Transit agencies and state departments of transportation have for years said, give us the money, we have the jobs, we need to get things going, so here is your opportunity. They have said, we can deliver. There are 1,400,000 construction workers out of work. Now, I'll say that when Bud Schuster and I moved the, he was chairman of the committee at the time in 1998, and we moved the T-21 bill. We had 3 million new construction jobs as a result of that legislation. We can do that again. There's 15% unemployment in the construction trades across the country. At a recent hearing, Carol Brown, chair of the Chicago Transit Authority, testified that they have an unfunded deferred maintenance backlog of $5 billion, $500 million of which can be obligated within 90 days. She said, quote, if you write me a check today, I'll be spending the check tomorrow, close quote. Governor Doyle of Wisconsin said, quote, there is not going to be any barrier on getting this thing done immediately. I think any governor would have a pretty hard explanation about why the state next door or the other state is actually losing the money, using the money while they are losing the money. He said further, we, quote, we are looking at what we can put out to bid before the actual grant is in hand. California, Commissioner of California, Will Kempton, on the conference call and again today in our committee hearing on rail issues, said, not only do we have contractor capacity, we have well over 100,000 building trades craftsmen out of work. We're getting 8 to 9 bids per contract, and they're coming in at 25% below engineering estimates. We're getting a good deal. We can deliver. The contractors are ready, he said. The contractor community is prepared. Transit options. Transit systems have options to buy 10,000 buses, $5 billion worth. Options for more than 1,000 rail vehicles, valued at $2 billion. They can be exercised in weeks, not months, weeks. We heard today from the Rail Car Institute that they're down 50% in orders. Even of those that were on backlog, they're down 50% because of the recession in the rail sector. We need this stimulus. We could put these to work. I reserve the balance of my time.
Chairman reserves the balance of his...
Well, I will yield myself time to respond to the gentleman from Iowa to, if I may have the gentleman's attention, that I have been on the phone, CBO has not, with the commissioners of transportation from the principal states and from the Association of Transportation Officials. They have committed to have projects obligated or under contract in 90 days for the first $15 billion of this funding and the next $15 billion in 180 days. And our committee is going to hold oversight hearings. Every 30 days we're going to hold their feet to the fire and a blowtorch to their bottom side to make sure that they deliver jobs in the time frame that we have, and they have said that they can do. So every state's going to be on call, on notice. This is dress rehearsal for the next authorization. We can't deliver jobs in this context. Then how are they going to do it in the next six-year authorization bill? So the CBO is very conservatively scored on the basis of previous history, not on the basis of the real world that we live in that I have insisted on.
I yield myself 1 minute to...
Gentleman's recognized for 1 minute.
...to commend the gentleman from Pennsylvania for the amendment that he offers to, in the spirit of our committee, to make even more firm our intention that the funds from our committee be stimulus, be in place to create additional jobs, not supplant money that states had already planned to use for highway projects, transit projects, aviation projects, but to ensure that the jobs created are additional jobs in this economy. We want them to continue with their program of projects planned for the current fiscal year, but that this recovery money be supplemental to, in addition to, and to clean up the backlog that states have for months and years complained to us that, by us I mean on our committee, that they need all this additional money. So this is a stimulus. Yeah.
Legislation provides for $1 billion in new starts for transit. And Houston Transit has been moving through the process, and we're working to accelerate its the consideration of its project to the Federal Transit Administration. And Mr. Nadler will soon offer an amendment to increase the funding for transit, so I'm quite confident that there will be enough capacity to accommodate the gentlewoman's concern. I just want to say I concur with the gentleman from Iowa that we required a maintenance of effort in all of those projects in our committee that had matching funds because we wanted to ensure that there are stimulus. And we want to keep the pressure on state and local government people to carry these projects out. So the gentleman's amendment is needed. It's important. It'll assure that we put jobs in place by June, and we ought to support this amendment. And I thank the gentleman for offering.
I thank the gentleman for yielding. I need not take the whole minute. The gentleman from Florida spoke well for both sides. But in our hearing, just a week or so ago, we heard very clearly from the major transit agencies in this country. They have options for buses. They have options on rail cars that can be exercised in days. And we heard from the producer companies, the original equipment manufacturers, they can ramp up production in to 35% in days, not weeks or months. These initiatives will create jobs. MARTA, the Atlanta Transit Agency, says we need 20 new buses, natural gas buses that will clean the air and increase ridership. They'll be produced in Minnesota. Muncie, Indiana needs rail cars. The rail cars will be produced in Boise, Idaho.
General's
so jobs will be created all over the country in Gilead, California.
General's time has expired. The gentleman from
California. Being produced. So